In this video, we will be demonstrating the Pulley Kit, the ES10 in the engineering science range from TecQuipment. With this kit, students can learn about simple, fixed, movable, and compound pulleys, the Western differential pulley, and the wheel and axle. By using pulleys or a wheel and axle, you can utilize the concept of mechanical advantage, i.e. a small effort can lift a large weight. All of these experiments fit within a sturdy plastic box with clear lid, each mounting onto a separately supplied engineering science work panel. Let's look at the simple and compound pulleys experiment first. With this, you can show mechanical advantage, establish velocity ratios, loss, and the efficiency of different pulley systems. The first part of this experiment is to look at the behavior of a fixed pulley set up like this. You choose which one of the weight hangers represents the load and which represents the effort. First up, you start by adding a load of 100 grams and see how much effort in grams is needed to lift the load. This is the data you need to record in the table in the workbook supplied. Go on doing this by increasing the weights at increments of 50 grams, recording the weight and effort required for lifting each. Now you can calculate the mechanical advantage, that is the load divided by effort, and then work out the efficiency as a percentage. Take your analysis to the next level by charting the results. The next part of this procedure looks at a moving pulley. Here the load is the weight on the weight hangers I've just done, but the effort is represented by the spring balance. When this is set to zero, you can then add a load of 100 grams, then take readings from the spring balance as the effort value. To study this further, you can fix one pulley and have one moving pulley, or fix two pulleys and have one moving pulley. By going through all of these, you can understand how using different numbers of pulleys can affect the efficiency. With more pulleys in this kit, you can experiment even further. Now onto the wheel and axle experiment. With this, you can show the mechanical advantage, velocity ratio, and efficiency of a simple wheel and axle and a differential wheel and axle. An obvious form of this in the real world is a bucket in a well, which uses a first order lever principle to help turn a rotation motion into a powerful lifting action. We're not focusing on levers here though. You can learn more about that in the Moments Kit, the ES3. In fact, what we're focusing on is the science of the use of a wheel and an axle together. Let's look at the first procedure in the experiment, which uses the smaller axle. With a differential wheel and axle mounted at the top of the work panel in portrait setup, you wrap a cord around each of the wheel and the axle neatly like this. Weights go on the axle end to represent the load. Think of the bucket in the water in the well. And weights go on the wheel end to represent the effort. Think of how much your arm needs to push to turn the handle on the well to winch up the bucket. Loads are applied starting at 100 grams with increments of 100 up to 500 grams. Each time you add weights for the effort, record what weight is required to lift the load up. The manual then takes you through how to predict the mechanical advantage and efficiency and how to calculate it using the experiment itself. You do this again using the larger axle that we've got here. With this information, you can look at the maximum permissible efficiency of both small and large axle systems and identify the losses that occur. Before we are done with this part of the kit, I mentioned differential axles at the beginning. Let's look at this now. This is where we use both the axles and wrap this cord around both in opposite directions. You add weights again for load, weight for effort, record in the specified 100 gram increments, and work out the mechanical advantage and velocity ratio. So now you can see how significant the mechanical advantage can be using a relatively simple system. Finally, we're going to look at the Western differential pulley. A range of crane systems use this setup utilizing the mechanical advantage of the regular differential pulley that we saw a few moments ago, combined with gears. These are sometimes used in garages to lift large, heavy parts. The operator pulls on the free side of the chain from the largest gear. The gear rotates, pulling the chain through the moving gear, which slowly raises as the chain loop on the operator side gets bigger. Back to the experiment. At the top is a balance stub mounted on a bracket that is fixed to the work panel. The load pulls down the chain from the largest gear, then the other weight hanger is hooked onto the other side as the effort. Like the other experiments, you add 100 gram loads, record the effort and calculate the efficiency. Then it's time to look at the questions in the manual and apply these concepts to real world scenarios, taking what you've learnt and putting it into practice. For more information about the Pulley Kit and the engineering science range from TecQuipment, click on the links. If you like this video, please do give it a thumbs up. Thank you for watching.